Total duration, inter-observer agreement. This one's different than total count because you're measuring a duration, but you still take the total duration during the measurement period of one observer and divide it by the total duration during the interval during the measurement period by the second observer. It's horrifically inaccurate as well. Again, that's why we have intervals, so you can break them down and make it more accurate to find out how well people are doing. So this isn't another one that you should probably not use, but we have to talk about it anyway because sometimes that's all you got. Right? And I get that. And we all get that. You just do the best you can with what you have. But this particular method grossly overestimates accuracy of inter-observer agreement, just like the total count does. So again, total duration, you're just taking the shortest duration divided by the longest duration, you know, the total durations, right, between the two observers. The shortest one divided by the longest one gets your ratio, multiply 100, you got yourself a percentage of agreement. Not that it's very accurate.